We're just checking my trajectory, and you can see here, I actually did get into orbit. And you can see after this long burn here, I check and I'm at 74. So
fine. I'll do it myself.
Hello and welcome to a KSP video where I try to go to a stable orbit using nuclear engines. That's the thing, like, Braid made a video a couple days ago where he got to a suborbital trajectory. You can argue that, like, a suborbital trajectory is a type of orbit, but here, I don't care about this. Like, I just was so annoyed by the end of the video looking at this. Yeah, he didn't make it to a stable orbit. Just like, you know what? I'm doing this. I have way more experience in KSP that I should admit. So I played this game for a long time. So I was like, you know what? That should not be the hardest thing to do. So I was just like, I have a couple hours, so I can do this. So I started first thinking, yeah, let's try to make everything reusable just to make a little bit harder. And yeah, it was not that easy, actually. Yeah, and it's not fully reusable, to be honest. So at first I was like, just an IO engine should be enough. Design engine should make like the last 500 meters second to orbit, and in like 3-4 minutes I was like, that should be fine. It was not. So with that in mind, I was like, now I need a big nuclear carrier. So to make the center of mass and the center of lift align a little bit, I tried to build the wings a little bit after, so to not have all the engines far back, so to have like the center of mass and the center of lift be a little bit aligned. At the same time, I'm using the wings that can carry liquid fuel, because guess what? Less dry mass. I think it is. I didn't make the math to confirm, to see how much better this is, but I hope that it is a little bit better. So this is just me adding all the landing gears, checking everything, just three nuclear engines, aligning all the center of lift. I was like, okay, I need to take off. So instead of going for a nuclear design right now, I just went for a JATO system, so jetted assisted takeoff. So instead of having a nuclear pusher, I just made like 5 juniors to just mimic one. So that's the thing, like, this is for now. Like, the end of the video, everything is going to be pushed by nuclear engines and nuclear engines only. Right now we have like jet engines, IO engines, but don't worry, this is going to be fixed. So I just went and flew the thing and it didn't accelerate. I was like, okay, we need more thrust. There's no way besides that. More thrust is necessary. So I did 2 more engines and back to testing. So just fire everything at the same time. Takes off more or less the same speed. I separate the jet engines. It's always funny for me how the jet engines just go up and out of the frame after you separate them. So, and it works. Works really well, actually. I didn't expect that this would work as well as it's working right now. I just go a little bit up, a little bit up, a little bit up, a little bit up, and just gets a little bit more speed, and separates. But the separation is too low. Let's be honest, that's a little bit above Mach 1. We need way more speed to get to orbit. So it's like, yeah, there's no way. We need nuclear engines because of the thrust that they provide. And so I was like, okay, we need nuclear engines, but we need not a lot of fuel. So instead of going for the 400 units normal engine, I was like, okay, we need less than that. So I went for the 2 wings, that 100 plus the nose cone, that's 80. I was like, that's enough. 280 units seems a lot. Spoilers, it's not. So 2 kilometers a second. Like, as you can see, that's a lot of speed for a Kerbal craft. And I attach everything and look. Yeah, doesn't look good. It just doesn't look good. So I tried some stuff. Like, no, we need to actually carry this thing like a like 905, 911, like Virgin Orbit. So let's just make this thing a strato launcher. So strato launchers are cool. They're not that useful, but they're really cool. So I just made a fake nose cone there because I've used the node for that. So hope that that didn't create a lot of drag. And at the same time, I was looking at the center of mass, center of lift, like, okay, we need more fuel. And I added more fuel to balance everything out, and at the same time, more or less, make everything out a little bit cooler. So that's the thing, like, don't make rafts just to be a giant bunch of parts that, like, don't look right. So I always try to make look a little bit cooler. So as you can see, it's really heavy now because of the extra fuel that I added. So that's 800 units of fuel, it's a couple tons at least. So I fire everything and it almost doesn't climb. Yeah, it can fly, but it doesn't fly too well. So yeah, it was like, okay, let's go for it. Let's go for it, because guess what? There's more fuel, so it should be able to get to a good orbit with this amount. Yeah, it doesn't. I just stopped the game for a second using mods, and it's just unstable. So a little bit of a mistake. The yaw problem, there's a little bit of a yaw problem in the space plane, because it's on top of the center of mass, so there is almost no leverage for the yaw. So, and the same time, like I said, was too heavy, so I removed the four tanks. But look where the center of lift is now. The center of lift is a tiny bit on front of the center of mass when the thing is empty. So this thing is 100% unstable, and I didn't notice this. So I'm just flying this plane thinking that it's going to work, but no, it doesn't. So this thing right now, it's stable because it's full of fuel, but the fuel that was on the front was removed. So now the craft, when burns, it just shifts the mass a little bit backwards with time. So at some point it just passes the center of lift, and when it passes the center of lift, it just loses control. So I was like, what's happening? I didn't notice that, so I was like, again. And mid-flight, I was just like, it seems fine, there's no problem with this craft, why it flipped last time, why is so unstable? And I go up, and in mid-flight, again, I have the same mistake. So I go back to the launch pad, and like, no, this is another mistake. So go back to the SPH, and just fix everything, moving the wings a little bit backwards. I move the plane, the carrier plane, a little bit backwards too, to make like the space plane a little bit forwards, to just push the dry mass of the nuclear engine and the capsule for, no, not the capsule, that's more a cockpit than actually a capsule. And it works. So this is more or less the second to last configuration of this plane, because it gets almost to orbit. Almost, that's the thing, I'm spoiling the video a lot, so this thing, it actually looks good, it actually can perform almost to what I wanted. So I separated, it's a clean separation, I'm really impressed, like the plane doesn't crash into each other, like when they separate, like one just goes down, the other goes up, and it's perfect. So I'm trying to keep the nose a little bit up, simply because I don't want to stay inside of the atmosphere. I have zero fuel, and I need 200 meters to get up, 210 actually. So I was like, yeah, I maybe can refine a little bit of the ascent. So maybe I can squeeze 200 meters a second extra on the ascent if I climb a little bit higher. So I was like, you know what, let's do the pusher. I'm just, for a long time, just using the J2 system, I was like, yeah, no, we need to push this thing with actual nuclear engines. So I added a bunch of nuclear engines, and for some reason the game started to lag. And the lag only happens inside of the SPH. Don't know why, but it only happens here. And when you right-click something, the game just freezes. You can see, like, every time I'm right-clicking, the game seems to more or less stop for a second. And I keep trying to build this and close the game, opening the game, and yeah, well, look at this, like, this is the final version of the game. So don't know why, maybe some mod that's causing this, but in the end, I made the thing, 22 nuclear engines, pushing this craft to separation, and it flies. Like, as you can see, the separation is not the most gracious thing for now. it just throws the craft to the left or the right, depending on where on the wiggle at the end of the runway you are, and all the engines just crash inside of the Cassie property. So like 22 nuclear engines just blowing up at the end of the runway is not a good thing. So I'm just calling this right now. All Kerbals are green because of nuclear stuff. It's not because their plans, not because of some the aliens. No, it's just nuclear. Like, this is just radiation problems. So I just climb up, separate everything as normal, and try to go to orbit using a battery ascent, and go to almost orbit. It's still suborbital, like I said. So I make a redesign. The problem is I didn't record, because first, I'm a noob at this, and second, the game was having too much issues. So, but the redesign is not a lot of new things. So there's a extra wing, so the wing on the space plane, there's now, instead of two, there's four, and all of them carry liquid fuel. So liquid fuel went from 280 to 480 units, and the carrier plane has now the big wings on the side. But the problem is, the big wings, I filled them with fuel, because thinking, okay, we have more lift now, so we can add a little bit more fuel. And it didn't work, because now the plane is just too heavy. So I was like, yeah, we just need a tiny bit of thrust to get to orbit with this thing. So I just added one extra engine, so now rising to six engines in the lower section of the carrier plane. I make finally the action group to not crash this thing inside of Cassie, and this is the final round. So separation, as you can see, all engines behind just stop working, the forward engines fire, there's no explosion now, noise in the background, so there's no danger for the Kerbals around Cassie. So that's the kind of things that I like to design. I'm not some monster that's just going to kill everybody, all Kerbals. So, and the thing climbs really well, like climbs more like the previous version. I had a little bit of an issue going a little bit to the right, so I'm just trying to compensate going to the left, flying. And now I separate, so it worked as well as before, but now we have more delta V on this section, so it should be able to compensate. And all of this delta V is being used on the upper atmosphere, where there's better ISP. So we are in a suborbital trajectory going to orbit. The maneuver is on the screen, the numbers are on the screen, like the delta V numbers, and everything is green, so there's enough. There's just enough. So that's one of the things, like, this craft is made by, I'm not an engineer, but like, there's this saying that, like, if you want to build a bridge that is almost falling but it's not falling, you call an engineer. This is something that, like, looks to be like on the verge of working, and it works, but still there's problems, like the backward section is still too heavy. So yeah, Val didn't survive this flight, but I can go back in time, so there's not much of a problem. So if you like this video, just subscribe to the channel. Not asking. So thank you and goodbye.